He's been on the Lafayette campus a long, long time. The Leopard baseball coach is with Mike Joseph.
Thank you, Gary. Here with Coach Joe Kinney, head baseball coach for Lafayette. 21 seasons, Joe. Unbelievable. Great to have you here. Appreciate it.
Mike, thanks. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you. Well, let's talk about it. I mean, 21 years, you were on this campus in 2000, the millennial turn. It's got to be obviously a whirlwind for you, and thinking back, some great memories.
Yeah, you blink and it's gone, and you know, it's been a great place to work. My kids were raised here. I had a daughter who went to school here. I live in the neighborhood. This was their backyard, so it's been a really great experience.
Yeah, obviously Lafayette's meant a lot to you, and you've had some incredible accomplishments here. Let's talk about the upcoming season. Let's get right into it. Obviously, a deep run last year in 2019 in the semifinals of the Patriot League. You've been to the Patriot League tournament six of the last 11 years, so everything's kind of on the uptick.
Yeah, last year I'd say it was a step in the right direction. We're excited about this year. Our players come back tomorrow. Practice starts on the 24th of January, so next Friday. So we're really looking forward to it. We have six guys in our lineup back, all our starting pitching back. So we think we have a deep team returning, and we also think we have a talented freshman class. So we're very excited.
You look outside, it doesn't look like baseball weather right now, but you'll get there soon enough. But let's talk about some of the players. Obviously, you get Trey Dura back, a strong up the middle. Justin Johnson had a great season for you. You got some pitchers back in Stern and Kramer. I mean, those guys can really play, and it looks like that nucleus is there, exactly what you're looking for this upcoming season.
Yeah, we have three guys in our lineup that were all league players. Trey, who you mentioned, is a senior. He'll be on our left field for us. Justin Johnson was a rookie of the year and also a first-team all-league player as a shortstop. He'll certainly be a key part of the lineup. And then Ethan Stern is a junior second baseman. He was also an all-league player. So they're going to lead us. Dylan Mangini was a freshman catcher last year, caught a lot. Colin Hardy, Jake Snagaki, Mark Glover are all guys that got, you know, a decent amount of playing time, so we're going to look to them. And then some other guys, Mike Landry, Drew Jansen, guys who have played, who've had experience that are going to certainly contribute. And then, as I said, freshmen are going to compete to start in a couple spots as well. On the mound, we're going to be led by two guys, two starters, two left-handers. Senior Brett Cryer and junior J.P. Woodward are going to be our top two. And then a bunch of others, Kyle Subers is a sophomore right-hander, Mark Anderson, senior left-hander. And then again, a host of freshmen and some other returning players who are going to do some good things for us.
If you had to put your finger on one thing in the Patriot League, is it pitching? Is it hitting? Is it base running? What is it, the number one thing, if you can feel real confident? Obviously, you got to have a staff.
I'd say experience first. Okay. You know, would be the first thing. And if you have it on both sides of the ball, then that really helps. You know, having a veteran pitching staff, and really not just a number one, but like a number one and a number two. So, like, for example, last year, Cryer went game three for us, and I thought he should have been all league. He was not, but he won four games in league play and was an anchor all the time, and it could be a number one. So having that is a real comfort zone, but then also having experienced guys in the lineup and more than one, because if one guy struggles, now you have another guy that's going to step up and do the job for you. So that's a huge piece. I think we have it. We obviously have to go out and prove it.
And you had great defense. You're third in the league last year in defensive efficiency, which is huge because you got to have those guys that can get those routine outs.
Yeah, Johnson and Stern are guys up the middle. I think we were third in the country in double plays. We averaged more than a double play a game. And, you know, it was almost like the pitchers pitched to contact, knowing ground ball is going to be two when there's a guy on base.
Confidence from a pitcher, right?
That's huge and on many fronts. Saves your pitch count. Saves your bullpen. It keeps the game flowing, keeps everybody in the game. There's just a whole lot to that. And that's certainly something we're going to build towards again this year and try to make it even better.
And we saw the video just last week about the incoming class. Give me a couple things about them.
A little smaller. We had a large class who are freshmen right now. Next year is going to be a group of nine guys. We think are talented, good-sized guys. Some corner players that maybe we didn't take as much this year that we think are going to be middle of the lineup guys. And then obviously pitching is always a key that you're looking to just continue to build that pitching staff. So we're excited about them, and you know, they got to finish high school and do their things, and we're looking forward to getting them here next year.
Nice group of kids. And Joe, I you touched on it back in December. This will be your last season here on the Hill. I mean, it's got to be a whirlwind. Give me one memory that you have.
You know, it's hard to point one memory. We won a championship, but you know, it's more than that. It's obviously all the people I've connected with, starting with the players 100%, but also assistant coaches, staff, people on campus who have helped us or you've just gotten to know socially. It's been a wonderful family environment for me, and I'm fortunate to say that I raised my family here, and fortunate it's still going to be in my life as I move forward.
Absolutely, and you've been a stalwart here. The things you've done here on campus, obviously the most wins in one season, the most Patriot League wins in one season, the facilities that you've obviously gotten done here with the help of Coach K-Mine, and obviously that it's been just fantastic to have you here, and you've done more than I think you know here at Lafayette for Lafayette Baseball.
Yeah, I really don't focus on that, I guess. I'm fortunate to be able to do what I do and have done for many years, and try to embrace every day and try to win that day, to be quite honest with you.
It's a great place to live and work. Joe, we can't thank you enough. Go have a great season this year. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Mike. I appreciate it.
Thanks so much. Gary, some of the best right here on campus. Back to you.
No question about it. We wish him a great year and certainly congratulate him on a tremendous career.